Shalom, brothers and sisters. Once again, it's the voice of Brother Tazad Duck. All praise is due to the Most High. For the record, I'd like to reserve all of my rights according to the Bill of Rights and the Constitution of the Federal Republic. This is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. Never have. This is for educational, informational, and entertainment purposes only. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent attorney and please be advised. If you decide to use this information and you fall on your face, this is your own fault because you did not research the information that was stated. Please take nothing that I state here or anything anyone else says for face value without doing your extensive research. With that being said, I'm going to continue on with how to respond in a court hearing for entertainment purposes. Now, if you haven't watched the first video, you're going to be lost and it's not going to make sense to you. So please go back and watch the other video. So, where was I before I ran out of time? Okay, so if the plaintiff is the state, you say, for the record, judge, I would like to place the plaintiff on the stand. So let the plaintiff be sworn in, and then you start questioning the plaintiff. And if the plaintiff is the state, you're going to address the questions to the judge, starting like this. Do you know of anyone else in this courtroom who has a claim against me? And that answer should be no. Next question. It appears that no one here has a claim against me. Therefore, my public business here is completed. I mean, you gotta gird up your loins like a man or a woman to be able to do this, to be able to say this. If you're a coward, it's just not gonna work. Just give it up. If you're a coward and you're gonna run and get a damn attorney to represent you when your case has never been presented, just forget about this. This is not for cowards. If you're gonna listen to this and you're gonna go back and act like a damn slave, then don't even come to this channel. You're wasting your time. You're wasting your time. If you're gonna act like a damn coward or a little sissy, then there's no point in watching this channel. This is not for the feeble-minded and those that wants to continue to be slaves to the sword. Now, with that being said, let me continue on. So if the judge should state the plaintiff said, or he or she, has a claim, then you're going to respond like this. If they claim that they have a claim against you, judge, you have the knowledge of the difference between a complaint and a claim. Furthermore, for the record, I would like to alert the court to the numerous willful acts of barbarity committed by the plaintiff's attorney in the plaintiff's original complaint in violation of, now, whatever state you're in. For instance, me, New York, penal code, and you cite that penal code or whatever state you're in, and the said acts are an excessive requisite of number and whatever counts it is that they violated. For instance, number of 3 counts to cause disbarment, because you want to go and try and get them disbarred for entertainment purposes. So the act of barbarity was designed with specific intent to deceive and mislead the court. And this is how you're going to respond for entertainment purposes. This court may choose not to take action to impose a Jewish punishment for barbarity, but take notice, I will file a criminal complaint with the appropriate agencies to cause disbarment procedures to commerce. Now, the agencies to which I refer is the Supreme Court and the state bar for whatever state you're in. For instance, New York State. Now, if the judge persists that a claim has actually been lodged against you, brother or sister, then you can either actually simply state that, judge, I hereby accept this case for value, and I'm exempt from levy, and I want the order of the court to be released to me immediately. Or, brother, sister, you could respond like, ask the judge for his judgment and state, for the record, judge, I need a copy of your judgment with your signature so that I may reject it and return it to you in accord with truth and lending. Now, this is, again, this is not for cowards. This is not for the feeble-minded. This is for men and women to have the courage to do this. Because, I mean, it's a scary thing standing in front of that judge or whatever, especially if you're doing it for the first time for entertainment purposes. Now, I want you to take note that after this, brother or sisters, if things are not going your way, you know, you're going to address the judge and go through the same steps that I just gave you in addressing the plaintiff. You're going to repeat these same things, but you're going to address the judge. They're going to be addressed and directed towards the judge. Excuse me. Now, after the order of the court has actually been released to you, then you're going to conclude with, it appears that there is no further public business for me to conduct here. So I'm leaving now. And then you walk out for entertainment purposes. Now you're in the valley of decision. You decide what you're going to do. I mean, I put it out there for training purposes, for entertainment purposes, for educational purposes. Now you decide what you're going to do with it. Many use, oh, I want to do this. I want to do this. I want to learn. You're not going to do nothing. First of all, you got to know who you are. Say, oh, I want to be a sovereign. I want to be a nationalist. Listen, man, who are you? Who are you? Are you a corporation? Are you a corporate fiction? Or are you a living soul created by the Creator and obligated to the duties and laws, statutes, and commandments of the Creator? Are you a made man? Made and transformed into a corporation submitting to the will of a clique of criminals that hide the criminology behind what is supposed to be a justice system, but it's just us, the oppressed, that they're actually utilized for collateral to cover up and pay for their mistake. And this thing has gone on far too long. Once again, my name is Brother Tazad Duck, and I said shalom. Peace and blessings upon all of you. May the Heavenly Father be with you. Walk with the Most High, you can't go wrong. Walk with man, and you're gonna get caught up. You're gonna get caught up. Don't follow man. Don't follow man. There's a divine force. There's an omnipotent force. And that's the force that you are to follow. Follow no man. Don't put your trust in man. Don't put your trust in Tazad Duck. I'm just an ordinary man, just like you. Don't put your trust in Robert Menard. Don't put your trust in any man. Put your trust in the Mashiach, and you'll be alright. I'm just a dispatch of information. I'm nothing. This is a spiritual journey. And the moment that you understand that, you'll begin to alter the way that you actually see things. Because then you will have insight and foresight. Foresight enables you to have the ability to see things before they occur. But insight enables you to be able to see into things and see the reality thereof. Shalom.